4x4 TV, the television show for back road enthusiasts and backcountry adventurers.
Okay, so now this is your outside collection? Or these kind are the ones that are for sale, or what?
Well, they're a little bit of both. This one here is kind of a cool cruiser. This is a pretty late model one. It's got factory wind wings, which we never saw in this country. It was made for warm weather countries. It's a true one-ton rated vehicle. It has factory air conditioning and power steering, removable hardtop. Over in Australia, they call them utes or tray backs. Because of the tray in the back. 90% of the vehicles that are brought into Australia are just basically a rolling chassis, and they produce these over there domestically. And what makes these really unique is the fact that you can put the sides down, you can actually forklift from all three sides. They're very, very utilitarian. This one also happens to have a full floating rear axle in it and disc brake front end. We're in the United States, I'm sure, as you know, we got disc brakes in 1976. Well, Australia really didn't get them until like 1982, 83. So it was much later when they got them. However, what they had is they had a 3-inch wide front shoe, so they had a heavy-duty drum brake, which we never saw in this country here.
Now, what about now? Has this been filled, or is this?
No, those are actually fiberglass. And this is also...
Well, all fiberglass. The tops, aren't the tops... On all the 40s are fiberglass.
Yeah, but these are steel. All pickup trucks are steel tops.
Really?
Yeah.
Can't keep up with it.
Yeah, there's so many variations.
Yeah.
This one here is a 1976. This one here has been modified as a crew cab. It's got a Ford six-cylinder cross-flow head engine in it, fuel-injected, which never came to this country. Once again, it's got the wind wings in it, long-range tank, one-ton rated. Compound load transmission in it. This one also, somebody's gone ahead and put disc brakes on it. Other than that, not really that unique of a vehicle. Mm-hmm.
And this also is an Australian?
Australian spec car. Runs very, very well.
Ah, and something close and dear to my
heart.
And
here's an American spec car that I have no interest in.
Yeah. Well, gee, sorry then. I do. Oh, and this has, we can't pass this up. What do you call this material?
It's called tough duck material.
Tough duck.
And it is very, very tough.
This is what we want to do to our 60, is put the tough duck.
I think you'd be very happy with it. It's very stain resistant, very tough material.
I like that, yep.
And we do produce them here at Specter Off-Road.
Now, are yours seat covers? Like we, you know, on the 40, we used your replacement seat covers. Now,
okay.
Are these?
This is a reupholstery kit.
Okay, that's, I couldn't even think of the term.
Yeah, but we do also have a slip cover to go over to protect what you've reupholstered.
Oh, so you have both. You have
correct.
Reupholstery kit in the tough duck and?
Yes.
I see, okay, well, I'll remember that.
Good.
Okay, one of my favorites.
Yeah, my favorite model also. When I first saw one 20 years ago, I said I had to have one, and it took me almost 20 years to get it. This is your typical troopy or personnel carrier, depending upon where in Australia you're from.
Okay.
Once again, a warm weather spec.
What's it called?
FJ45.
45.
Yeah, this is a 45. Right. And they actually produced this vehicle up to about April of 86, I believe.
Oh.
Where the 40 series, they stopped the production in the 10 of 84, where this one continued on beyond that. This vehicle here is the vehicle of choice these days among the surfers in Japan, because they'll go anywhere. You can put your board inside, you can sleep on them. However, in its day, when it was being sold, it was obviously the Suburban of Australia.
Yes. Uh-huh.
True one-ton rated vehicle, holds a lot, has opening cargo windows all the way around, full floating rear axle.
Same engine as the 40 would have in it?
It has a 2F motor in this one here. Same as an FJ40. The roof comes off on it like an FJ40, very, very heavy though.
I bet.
And they made this in a soft top version also.
Oh, that's interesting.
Yeah, and this one here has external rollover protection on it.
What's the wheelbase on this?
Boy, this off the top of my head, I don't know the answer to that. It would be the same as a 45 pickup truck because it's the exact same frame.
Okay. All right.
They just mounted one more tab on it to hold the body on it. And basically it's all FJ40 except stretched out a little bit.
Now, does this have 16 inch?
This one's got 15 inch on it, but it originally had the 16s, but it has that compliance plate from the government that allowed him to change it.
To change to the 15, so he could get a wider profile.
Correct.
Now, in Australia, what are they doing? Are they running wider tires or narrower tires?
Well, they all come with the narrow tires, but one has the option of running wider tires, and a lot of them doing, quite a few of them are still original.
Okay, because typically we call it the, I don't know, the safari look or European look, because they all seem to have the narrower tires. But, you know, obviously over here, we all go to the wider tires for more flotation.
So. Correct. And it has, obviously, your roll bar, sidebar protection, rollover protection on it.
It's got some heavy-duty extra stuff.
Yeah, this one is ready to go camping in. It's also a dual fuel. It'll run on propane or gasoline.
And that's something that they do a lot over there, too.
Quite a common conversion.
Wow, now here you've got a lineup.
Yeah, we have some other unique vehicles here. This is a another late model pickup truck with factory factory power steering in this one. 2F motor, 4-speed, compound low transmission. The canopies on the back of these are very, very common aftermarket.
Oh, yeah, okay.
And it's a very good running machine. These vehicles, you just can't kill them. I'm sure you know that yourself.
I know that. But we're trying to, you know, we're wanting to resurrect one, so we can't kill it. Another truck.
This happens to be a 76. Happens to have a stock bed, quite rare. One ton rated, typical like all the other ones, nothing too clever.
Okay, and then another pretty unique.
And this is the next 70s. Generation of Land Cruiser. When they discontinued the 40 series, they went to what they call the 70 series. This one happens to be a 75, like a 45, it's the extended wheelbase. Comes with a 2H diesel, 5-speed air conditioning, power steering. This one happens to have the PTO winch on it also.
Now, did they make these just like a 40? Did they make
did.
A short, a
they
two-door,
did.
Real short one, and
correct.
Then a long?
Oh, okay. And that, once again, would have been a BJ70, FJ70.
Okay. Did they make a four-door? Like a FJ60? Did they make a?
No, they don't. No. The 60 was produced concurrently with this model also.
Oh, okay. Oh, yeah, that's right. This is an 87, so it would be. Now, does this have bench seat? Did all the troop carriers have the? They had
well,
the
what they did
the
is
side.
Most of them had forward, or excuse me, side-facing seats like you see in the FJ40.
Oh, okay.
However, this one has had been customized to forward-facing seats, and once again, it does have a compliance plate from the government on it.
Okay. Well, Marv, you know, we walk around, look at all these old cruisers, and other, of course, in my factory-supplied Volvo.
Mm-hmm.
There is something new here.
The 21st,
a real Land Cruiser,
the 21st century is here too, yeah.
So you do drive a real car.
I do drive a real car, yeah. But I do generally drive the older ones.
Do you?
Yeah, I do.
Well, you don't live too far away. So
do not.
Okay, that makes a difference. You know, that's why we didn't drive our FJ or 60 or 40 down here. Just too long a drive.
I see.
But you know what? I got to thank you. This is like, you know, this is like Disneyland to a kid for somebody into Land Cruisers to come here and look at all this. And I know that most everybody, you know, around the country is going to have the chance to do this.
Mm-hmm.
So it's really neat. I appreciate you opening your doors so that we can show this to everybody. And what a treat. What a treat. I mean, this, and plus, I guess if I found one thing out too, it's that you, what's the Christian saying? You walk your talk. You talk your, well, whatever the thing is. Because you're into cruisers.
I am.
Now I know when I call up and need some of these parts out of the catalog, I'm dealing with somebody that knows what they're talking about. Marv, thanks a lot. I really appreciate it.
Doug, I thank you kindly for the compliment, and it was a pleasure having you here, and you're welcome anytime, and if I can do anything for you, don't hesitate to let me.
Well, you know what? I do have that list of my Land Cruiser parts I need. Where is it? It's too long to show here.
Anytime.
All right, thanks, Marv. I appreciate
it. All righty.